Herzlich willkommen. I welcome our guest today at the Asian Center for Flood Control, Dr. Francisco Villanueva, Dr. Frankie, the President of the Metro Angeles Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Maxi. Dr. Frankie, ¿cómo está?
I'm good, and I'm happy to be your guest right now.
Frankie, I thank you and the Maxi for supporting us and supporting the introduction of a pilot training for flood control in the province of Pampanga. The project is supported by the German government, as you know, through the governmental institution SEQWA, located in the city of Bonn in Germany. But before we talk about the flood control training, what has been established here, let us spend some minutes to talk about the flood situation in the Philippines. Can you please describe our viewers what is the flood situation about in the Philippines? What does it mean when there is heavy rain and when there are flash floods?
Oh, well, the Philippines, as you know, has always been in the path of typhoons, but with climate change, this has become more severe. They're coming now at more alarming frequency, and the magnitude has really gone up the past few years.
Like in other parts of the world as well, huh?
Yes, but I understand that the Philippines is now among the top five countries most affected by climate change, and it's really very disheartening, because every time we have floods right now, well, everything stops, okay? The streets get flooded, people stop traveling, property get destroyed, and sometimes lives are lost. So it's about time that we've started looking at this and dealing with it in a more proactive manner.
Yeah, it is not only about business, and it is more about saving lives and protecting people, right? And that is one approach here at the Asian Center for Flood Control. Let me explain what has been done in the past, and that was also under your contribution. We have trained 10 Filipinos in a 3-week flood control intensive training program. Furthermore, we have educated 52 Filipinos in a 4-day flood control technical orientation training. And we have educated 64 Filipinos in a 1-day flood control awareness training. Did you pay attention? How many Filipinos did we educate?
That's 126, Andy.
Oh, it's very good. Very, very good. You always impress me. And that is really a lot. And we started at zero, you know that. And it is really helpful to get support from institutions, especially from SEQWA, from the German government, and to do something good together. And of course, we also need the support of the local chambers. Your Metro Angeles Chamber of Commerce, Maxi, helped a lot. And I would like to say thank you at this
It was
time.
Our pleasure, Dr. Andy, our pleasure.
In the Philippines, they say bola bola, but I know you mean what you say. And the same for me. Do you remember in 2012, what was your impression when I told you first what the plan is, the establishment, the creation of a flood control center here in Pampanga? What did you think when I told you the first time what we wanted to do?
Well, initially it was something like coming off the field, because here you are, a country from a temperate region that does not have that flood problem that we have coming in.
Oh, we have.
Oh, you do.
In Germany, we have a lot of flood problems, especially at the eastern part, and before at the along the riverside of the Rhine, but at the Elbe in the eastern part. So we are well experienced, by the way.
Yeah? Oh, then good. Well, but what was amazing was, hey, maybe we've been dealing with this problem in the most primitive manner. We use sandbags, or people have hollow blocks in their houses, and they put furniture on stilts or move them on the second floor. And it's really not perhaps the optimal way to deal with this problem. And we're really happy, because I've always respected German technology for precision and for robust design. So, hey, maybe we can have something more positive now in dealing with this perennial problem.
We hope so too, and it was very interesting when we were talking to the participants here at the training. During the trainings, we learned a lot from them, and we learned sometimes how difficult it is to change the things. But one thing that was the same answer everybody gave to us was that everybody can contribute and can do something. That means it starts with garbage, for instance, because the garbage is blocking the canal system, and when the canal system is blocked, there is flood. So that does not cost money. It is very easy to do. You have not to invest in technology, but of course, if you really want to get rid of the problem, people must invest. And what we want to contribute is here with this training center is to tell the people, think twice and think wisely before you invest your money, because at the end it could be too expensive, and it must not be expensive. So what was the contribution of the Maxi at the end? Can you just describe that for our German viewers? How was the cooperation at the beginning when we started?
Well, we've always been talking, either virtually or personally, and I think, first of all, we've helped try to establish a location for you, and we've identified the Clark area because it's right in the middle of a province that is noted for floods.
Let's talk a little bit about Clark, that's good.
And of course, it's a free zone, so should we require importation of materials, it would be very easy. We're by the airport, and at the same time, right now, the Clark is being viewed as a center for disaster, because right now it's very strategic in location. It's not flood prone, but it is very close to areas that are prone to floods. So from this vantage, we are in a position to help a lot of people in its environs. And then of course, we work together in identifying who to talk to, how to get yourself established here, and more importantly, who to train. 126 is a good number, but if we're not training the right people, it will not redound to much benefit. I think you made a good choice on who to train, and from then on, hopefully we can train more people so that this awareness that you're creating, this empowerment, becomes more prevalent in our country.
That is indeed our target, and we want to do so. And recently, last week, the inventor of the RS technology, of the RS barriers, Rainer Stepanek, has been here, and not for the first time and not for the last time. So he will come back, and at this time I have to mention, you know already, but for our viewers at home, Rainer Stepanek is a typical German entrepreneur, and he invented the RS barriers in 1990, so that means 25 years before. And in the meantime, more than 21,000 applications have been installed all over the world in more than 14 countries. And that works very well in flooded regions in the Netherlands, in Germany, in Canada, in the United Kingdom, in France, Italy, eastern parts of Europe, and in Singapore as well. Just one example, that is the protection of against flood in Terminal 2 and Terminal 3 at the Changi Airport. And so we are very confident that it will also help the Filipinos and other Southeast Asian inhabitants. And that is a business part of the program. Yeah? And of course, both will work together. Without training and awareness, as you mentioned, it cannot work, and companies cannot become successful. And at the end, I come back to Clark, what you mentioned. For the Clark Freeport Zone, it is important that investors come, of course. And perhaps at another time, we can talk about how we can attract more investors from Germany and from Europe to bring here to the Clark Freeport Zone.
Well, I'm really glad that people like you have faith in the Philippines. Right now, it's one of the fastest growing economies. It's an emerging market, and I think there's a lot of promise here. And with the support of people like you, your government, I'm sure we can cover more grounds.
We also are very sure, and we have done the first step, and now I have the honor to give to you, as a president of the Metro Angeles Chamber of Commerce and Industry, our awareness flyer, how to protect yourself against flood. And that I hope will be shared by you to all your colleagues and members at the Chamber of Commerce, and to don't hesitate to give it to all your friends and business partners. And of course, you can get more later. Yes. And we have done more. We have also developed a 10 real safe tips flyer on how to keep your home safe from flood. And that is especially made for residentials. And yeah, have a look on that and share it. And there is a third part I want to give to you. There is social media activity, and of course we all know Facebook. All the people are using it, especially here in Southeast Asia and in the Philippines, and that is what we distribute and where we inform the people about the ACFC trainings. And of course it can be found at the Facebook website. Perhaps one of your colleagues will make use of it, and it would be a pleasure to continue with the MACSI, the Metro Angeles Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and especially with you, Dr. Frankie. I thank you very much for this talk. And now at the end, do you want to send a message to the German people, to the German government?
Oh, well, yes. First of all, I'd like to thank the German government, the German people, and of course, especially you, for coming to our country and bringing this technology that will save a lot of lives and save a lot of properties. And of course, if you're talking about competitiveness as a country, I think continuity is essential. And with the help of technologies like this, we can maintain our continuity even during floods. So business will go on as usual, even with floods, if we use your technology. Thank you very much. And we will spread this. And I think maybe we can save a lot of lives just by doing so.
Dr. Frankie Villanueva, I thank you again for the support and this talk. Goodbye and auf Wiedersehen.
Yes. Thank you very much.